Hello everyone, Gil from Motorcycle Sound Systems Miami. We're here today to discuss some products that are new to the motorcycle industry, but they're definitely not new within the hi-fi, high-end speaker industry at all. Those products are BNC speakers and Chade. Both products are Italian, BNC being the parent company to both. These are very high-end products that play phenomenal. We've already installed it on several of our bikes. We're very happy that we picked up this line. We've done a lot of work with them, working hand by hand with the folks from BNC and Chade, and pushing the product. There's been some conversation about it, but unfortunately a lot of people just have not decided to work with it. Therefore, they really don't know at all, to tell you the truth. So we went ahead and decided, let's do this video. Let's talk about it. Let's explain what we have here. What is BNC? What is Chade? Some of their specifications and their applications. So first of all, BNC being the parent company is established in 1946 out of Italy. They've been making speakers that long. It's been a lot of research and development, all made in Italy, and their product is just at the highest level. Chade is a subordinate company to them. Chade has been around for 67 years as well. They are not new at all from within the speaker world. So these products have been around. So let's go with one product at a time. Let's go first with Chade. Chade is the product that's been spoken about recently more for several reasons. So what we have here today is three other products within the motorcycle industry that we believe is going to be used the most. So first of all, is their CMI 160. This is a beautiful new denim mid-bass speaker rated at 70 hertz all the way up to 4K. The woofer is a 2-inch voice coil, denim. Look at that design. 2-inch voice coil on this thing. 450 watts continuous power handling. We installed this week on one of our in-house bikes. Kevin, we have moved up to the new featherweight categories, which is 10-inch woofers. And we'll talk about that here in a few. We're actually gonna post this video today. But this speaker right here, we tuned it on his bike down to 90 hertz out of 12 dB, and we ran it up to 3,700 till we can phase it with the tweeters. And we are getting great results. The thing sounds beautiful, nice hits, nice vocals. We're looking forward for the woofer to break in a little more so we can then go back and retune and challenge it more. Now we like that Motorcycle Sound System play around the 4,700 hertz is normally our cutoff that we like. But this woofer right here, very good. The price is very competitive with the other products that are out there. Retails somewhere around the 150, give or take, or a little more. Compared to its competitors or speakers equal to it, is priced correctly. And then we have this thing. This is a work of beauty right here. This is actually on my bike that we showcased this woofer at Leesburg. This 8-inch is just phenomenal. This thing is phenomenal. This thing drops down to 70 hertz as well, plays all the way up to 8K. Power handling of 500 watts RMS. On my bike, on the Tour Pack, we actually have it at 200 watts. And on the gains on the DSP, it is turned down almost half. Because if not, it will just take over the bike and start canceling out a lot of the other things on the motorcycle. This woofer is just phenomenal. Just phenomenal. Great design and the way it sounds. Also well priced within this competition. I believe this woofer is somewhere around the $185 each, but this is just a phenomenal piece of equipment. All the Chade equipment is 4 ohms. They're not bringing out 8 ohms. Chade has been around with the car industry a lot in the U.S. They approached us and to start on the motorcycles, so they're not new to what we're doing. And then they have their 10. This is the CM250. Comes both in neodymium and ferrite. We installed this on Kevin's bike, the neodymium one, I will tell you, this thing is plays low, plays clean. This is a true mid-bass, and you're getting true mid-bass sound. You put this woofer and this driver in the right environment, and you're gonna be nothing but extremely happy. It is priced correctly. This is retail at $205. We are playing this on Kevin's bike at 50 hertz on the high pass at an 18 dB, and 450 on the low pass. It's in the right environment. It's on OEM factory bags. The bags are reinforced, because they are, and the port, the map came up to 3x3. We are using a precision port, flared out, and the bass is just so clean. It is just so clean, nice and deep. We're giving it 400 watts RMS. I would tell you that we were very skeptical about this woofer because of its specifications, but it's like anything else. You know, my mentor Henry from the Funk Shop always preached to me, you have to get your hands dirty with the equipment to say that it does or does not. And we have. We have pushed this product with working with the BNC folks and the Chade folks, and we have come down, you know, we've realized what its true capabilities are. So we're playing down at 50 hertz. It has an FS of 57. But on the motorcycle, you know, on the bags and that environment that it had, it sounds just beautiful. That video will follow. I suggest you definitely wear headphones. It is very clean, deep bass at 400 watts RMS. So now all products of BNC are waterproof, both in and out is their design. Waterproof, I have to, you know, we all know about waterproof. You talk waterproof, people are thinking about sinking a speaker in the water. That's just being ridiculous, you know, but we're talking about getting sprayed on water, both sides. It is waterproof. It's actually on their data sheet that these speakers are waterproof. This is Chade's new mid-bass. Real mid-bass, not a what's happening today. Drivers that are being called mid-bass that have all the parameters of a subwoofer. I mean, when you're looking at a woofer that has 11 millimeters of X-Max or more with an FS of 36, I don't think that's a mid-bass whatsoever. So, but this woofer right here, our brothers of SPL Baggers have already field tested. This is the PM257. They've already tested this side by side with the Bema Power X's, and they're keeping this woofer on. I'm not saying it's better than the Power X's. Like I said, there's parameters for all that and what you plan on doing. But we are OEM builders. That's our thing. We're not into the big bikes, you know, the Trailer Queens, the show bikes that go only to the show and back. We are into OEM. And I will tell you, this speaker plays phenomenal. According to Gino, it's playing on a 3K Sound Digital down to 40 hertz, ported at 4 inches, and the sound is phenomenal. The deep end bass, and we're looking forward to install it. We have a bike here that we're building all Chade. We've already built the environment for it. It's semi of an OEM bike. You know, it's not a big custom bike, but the bags have been reinforced, the bags have been sealed. It's been ported accordingly, and we're looking forward to this build. Once again, this is another woofer that's waterproof, rated as waterproof. So if you know, these OEM bikes that are using outside mounts, you know, these woofers will last you far more than some of the other brands that are straight out paper that are not designed for the elements. But, and that's key to the motorcycle industry. You know, so do some of these products probably are far better and its quality of sound and what, you know, some of these great tuners are able to get out of them? Yes. But can they go out there and ride from Miami to Savannah, Georgia, like our friend Ron on the Dirty Bitch bike, and the woofer really survived the elements of how he rides? we already seen a couple of brands that we won't mention that are high-end brands that won't last. You know, they won't last a rider like him 4 or 5 months. Now, these speakers are designed for the elements. This is just a great, awesome speaker. It's rated at 800 continuous watts. It's, I think it's almost a 3-inch voice coil. So it's a huge voice coil on it. X-Max, I believe it's somewhere around 7, give or take, maybe a little less. And we're looking forward to working with it. And then we move on to BNC. Now, BNC is a very high-end product. It is, there's so much engineering and development on these products. We've already built 3 bikes with this, with the assistance of BNC to ensure that we're powering everything correctly, tuning everything correctly, so we can get the max out of it. This woofer right here, in my opinion, for the motorcycle industry, is probably the best woofer that they make, this driver. It is probably going to dominate in the industry. It is a 6 NDL44. They're 8 ohms. They're developing a 4 ohm as well. The downfall, of course, we all see that it is square, but they do drop in both road glides and street glide pods. No modification. The only difference is, you know, securing the speaker, similar to the Bemas, similar to the Fatal Pros, is just securing the speaker, maybe with the through bolt, longer screw, you know, drive through the pod, specifically on the road glide. On the street glides, right in place. Just drops right in. There's scourging, no interference whatsoever. But this thing right here, this thing plays down to 70 hertz all the way to 6,000 at 450 watts RMS, continuous power handling, not peak. We are playing this on King John's bike at 400 watts each. We are playing it at, you know, our cutoffs that we like. We're down to 90 hertz through 4,700, and this thing is phenomenal. The vocals that come out of this is incredible. The low end that you're getting up front out of this woofer is actually amazing. The mid-bass that you're getting out of this woofer. It's an 1.5-inch voice coil. No, actually, I take that back. I think it's 2 inches. I'll come back to you on it, but I'm pretty sure it's 2 inches. The excursion, I think it's somewhere around 3 millimeters, which on a 6.5, that's a lot. And this woofer just, it's my go-to for now on. I have it on my bike. And we're playing on a lot of bikes, so the sound is just incredible. They're priced correctly. They're somewhere around the 150 something, 160 something. So they're right there with all his competitors. And they have their coaxial. This also is a beautiful piece of equipment. This is the 6HCX518. This is also an 8 ohm independent. We install this also on our bike on the lower fairings. Also down is rated to 70 hertz. The excursion, you know, waterproof, it's just another version of the NDL. A compression horn plays beautiful. We are playing it down to 1,000 hertz and open, bandpass open all the way. And this thing sounds phenomenal. The vocals that come out of the compression horn are beautiful. The mid-bass punch that you get out of this 6.5, once again, waterproof. Rated to them on their data sheet, so it's not something that we're making up. What's beautiful, what's great about BNC is they answer for their product. When I mean answer, no hassle. It's true customer service. We've had 1 or 2 issues with the woofer, obviously because we're pushing it, you know, and they're asking us to push it. 0 questions asked. You know, we had and just taken care of. I asked them and challenged them, so are we gonna get the same service with our customers if we have issues, like you're catering to us? It's not the same when you're testing, right? And they have guaranteed us that they will. And I have no doubt. They back up their products, and I mean, seriously back up their product. And this thing is just, you're gonna love it. Now, it is a little bit pricey, but it's comparable to its competition. You know, this compares with the Bema. I put them hand in hand together. I am not one to sit here ever. You guys, you know, folks never hear me say, well, this speaker's better than all of them. I will never say that, because there are just so many different variables. to actually determine and say, well, this speaker is the best than this one. I will say that's not true neither way. But, you know, they're at the same level. You know, they've been going at it in Europe forever, and they're at the same level. So it's priced around $256, $260 each. Also fits perfectly in the road glides and the street glides. And the street glides just drops in. And this is the perfect application. That's what we've been using on the street glides in order to prevent putting, you know, tweeter drivers, 25 millimeter drivers cutting into the fairing. This thing just falls, drops right in there, play the compression horn down to 1,000, you know, 1K, and bandpass open the rest, and you're just gonna have a great time with it. And then we have the woofer that we've been working with now on several builds, several occasions. This is the BNC, the 10NW64 mid-bass, 8 ohms. It's a great mid-bass driver. Some of you will say, well, you know, I've seen that design before. Well, it's similar, you know, in the online magnet. It's got a 3-inch voice coil. It's rated to, it has an FS of 57, but this is where playing with the speaker and understanding what you're doing and that your tuner knows what they're doing can get the max out of this. This woofer is both waterproof, rated waterproof in and out. We have installed both this one and the 76. The 76 is a higher version. The 76 is on my bike. 600 watts continuous power. We've already installed this on two bikes. The sound is phenomenal. It's so full and rich. The low end, it's nice and clean, hits hard. We have the cutoff that we're doing right now on this is 55 Hertz at a 24 dB. We are, you know, we're still pushing the product. We're probably gonna start testing some more this week now that the woofer on Juan's bike and John's bike have broken in some more, and probably come down to 50 Hertz at an 18, see what we get there, do some retouching on some certain frequencies and see what we can do. But it's a phenomenal product. Definitely an OEM speaker. This is for OEM bikes. This is definitely for a rider, a long distance rider, a hard rider, the guy that every bike night that just cannot go from here to corner if he's not on his motorcycle or she for that matter. This is a phenomenal speaker. The 76, it's the big brother to this. It's the same parameters as far as the design, just greater power handling, greater voice coil. The 76 is rated at 800 continuous watts. We've had it on a 3K with very little time to properly tune on OEM reinforced backs, sealed. Not some big aftermarket backs. Too much power for that environment. It's not that I couldn't handle it, it's just the environment is important. You know, we get a lot of people tell me, well, I want a 3K on my bike. I have OEM bags that are open, unsealed, they're not reinforced. Well, yeah, the woofer can do it because that's what it says, but the bag can't take it. So it's the same situation. So I went down to a 1601, and it just sounds beautiful. The sound is just gorgeous, clean. The sound is just full of warmth. Different from other products that are out there, I just scream and yell. Tuning is everything. We all know this. We've all learned this in the motorcycle audio world. But this speaker is just great. You know, we're very happy with all these products. So the takeaway is pretty simple. It's, you know, talk to people who have been working with the product. It's no different from some of the other brands that now we've seen over the last 4 or 5 years or maybe more. I won't mention names because I don't want to drop names, but this is all in the positive sense, right? That they started off, nobody knew who they were, and it took a couple of shops to work with it and push the product to its limits or push the product to its capabilities, and then it picked up. These folks have been around for a long time. They're not some new stuff. They're not a company that went to China and licensed and put their sticker on them. These are products that there's research and development on it. There is a lot of quality work to it, and the willingness to cater to our industry. The BNC folks in Chade have already talked about making the 6th and the 8th in coaxial, which is important for us in the motorcycle world. You know, so it would behoove them, if they want to be competitive, to do these things, and they are. To have this woofer that plays down to 70 hertz, clean, and be a coaxial as well, you know, having the best of both worlds in round, it's just phenomenal. And being priced correctly. The 8-inch woofer from BNC is being sent to me. It's not a product that's done in the U.S. or used in the U.S. We still don't know how it plays, obviously. Once I get it, I'll put it on my bike because I want to do my entire bike BNC. But if the BNC product does what it's been doing versus the Chade product, I can't wait to put that 8th in on my bike and the Tour Pack. It has phenomenal ratings with 70 hertz at the low, at the high pass, all the way up to 7K with an FS, I think, of 59 on that 8. And that's just phenomenal. That's just really phenomenal. You have that on lid, so you have that on Tour Pack pods, and a 4-speaker setup, 6-speaker setup, and you have nice deep end if your tuner knows what they're doing. So feel free to call us, and we'll give you all the information that we can. Everybody have a good one.
Don't get upset, girl, that's just how it goes. I don't love you, hoes, I'm out to die. And I